It's surprising to most folks we talk to that NASA even has to concern themselves with wildlife and habitat. But when you tour Kennedy Space Center, it all sort of makes sense. Hi, my name is Eric Reyier. I'm a marine biologist here at NASA's Kennedy Space Center.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Ahr. I'm a fisheries biologist here at NASA's Kennedy Space Center.
We provide NASA the information that helps them avoid some of the impacts to wildlife and habitat.
I track lots of fish species as well as other aquatic organisms. No, I definitely didn't think this like job existed. It's funny because when I talk to people, they ask, where do you work again? I'm like, oh yeah, I work at the Space Center. And they're made it like go, what are you doing there? And so the joke is that we always say we're sending sharks into space with lasers, but then we're saying, no, not really. We actually are tracking the animals.
No one thinks of NASA or KSC specifically as having any marine science type of careers, right? I fell into this job as a graduate student. I thought it'd be a 2-year thing, and here I am now 23 years later. Here at KSC, we actually focus more on habitat and behavior issues, making sure that the fish and the habitat they need are protected as NASA goes about launching rockets. One of our main projects is to understand basically the movements and the preferred habitat of some of our most common and economically valuable sport fish and sharks and turtles.
It's really important to monitor and see what potential impacts there might have from the space program and everything on the wildlife here. And then we can really look at ways and suggest ways that might help mitigate some of these impacts and make sure that NASA gets to complete their mission and we get to complete ours by preserving the local ecosystem.
What looks like a giant chunk of barnacles is actually an acoustic receiver. When they're brand new, they look like this. So this is a hydrophone and a data logger, and they are basically underwater listening stations. So very informative for determining where animals spend a lot of time, inshore, offshore movements, where we think they might be spawning.
We get this equipment back, but it's been out in the ocean. It's pretty much in the lagoon or in the ocean nonstop, so it gets lots of barnacles. We need to clean it off. We need to make sure it's all good to go before we put it back down. When we pull up our acoustic receivers, we download the data off of them. And from there, we have a lot of animal detections, like way too many that you wouldn't be able to just look through it in a spreadsheet and know what's going on. So you have to automate this process and make computer programs that pull out the information that you want and summarize it. We want to stitch together the data we get to find out what these animals are doing and what habitats they prefer, where are important areas. And so we really need these habitat models to be able to do that.
Fish like it here. There's been several studies now that have shown that we have more fish, including more sport fish. Those sport fish are bigger. When these sport fish leave, they're actually helping sustain fisheries outside the boundaries of KSC. It's pretty well documented now that because Kennedy Space Center NASA is here, fisheries as a whole in the Cape Canaveral region throughout the Indian River community is much healthier than it would be. That's why we study it, and that's why we hope it stays like this forever. If folks are looking at NASA as a career path, we think of engineers and astronauts, but there's definitely a lot of different options.
So I actually went to Arizona State University and I got my bachelor's in biology. I heard a lot that it doesn't matter what you first get your degree in, it just matters on the experience. And that was definitely true of, having a degree in biology isn't that much different than having a degree in marine biology. It's just if you have those opportunities to get out on a boat and everything, which I didn't even see a boat until grad school. So it was a little bit of a late blooming type of scenario.
A lot of students maybe are concerned they're not born with the aptitude or the skills to do the job, but maybe they want to anyway. What I've discovered over time is that those skills are earned. They're not something that you're born with. If you put in the time, you can dictate your career path to a large degree. You don't have to be born being great at math or a coder. As long as you put in the time and have a plan, you might be able to get there anyway.